Hello everybody, this is Einar from Unity Center. Today Daniel Mittell is back again, and he had some interesting news he wanted to share with you. So Daniel, welcome back. And you're expert on energies, and lots of people are wondering what is happening now in 2014, what kind of energies, what is going on?
I'm really happy to be here, very old friend of mine, Einar, beautiful Norway. I would invite all people from all over the world to come now in Norway. You can't imagine, it's a miracle, the beautiful weather and beautiful energy. Last week I was in Bucharest and 2 weeks ago in Mexico, and the same discussion, people are talking about energies, what's going on. And a lot of questions. Why I wake up in the morning, I have a headache, why I get stressed suddenly out of nothing, why I do all these things. And 2014 and 2015 actually are two very important years, because our energy, our DNA gets a bigger charge of feminine energy, which started to move in 2012, right? So 26,000 years our Earth was in male energy, and now it's in, we say, female, feminine energy. Now it's very interesting, because people get different feelings, different energies, and people cannot understand why they go through all these changes and what's going on. Because the feminine energy is completely different, and we have to start to change ourselves. I always used to say we are a generation of sacrifice, because our body got some male energy, we were born in male energy, and now, especially after 2012, we started to have female energy. So we, people who are on this planet today, we call the generation of transit, right? And we get both. And to change is not easy, believe it. If we think changing is easy, it's not, because we've got belief patterns, and we got habits, we got a lot of emotional trauma charges from years and years, and we like to stay in this energy. We love this energy, male energy. We like schedules, we like discipline, but feminine energy is completely different. It's flowing. Whatever you are saying now, 1 second later is change. The universe is changing continuously, and it's a time when the Earth energy completely is in the same way with the universe. We change in the same time. So whatever we've done 5 minutes ago is not available anymore. So basically, the energy and the whatever we are doing today, it should be in a natural way. It should be, I would say, like Eckhart Tolle, now, the power of now. I just finished my book now. It's called This Now is Eternity. It's about my experience in Tibet for years there. And it was time to write this book, because it's true. Now, here is all what we have. So it's nothing else. Forget about the past. Forget about the future. Enjoy this time. Go outside this beautiful sun. Stay in the park there and enjoy the time. This is the most important thing, to be in the moment now. You like an ice cream? Go and buy an ice cream, for God's sake. Enjoy that ice cream. Don't start to analyze the future, the ice cream will destroy me and all of it. No, just enjoy the moment. And people, believe it or not, they cannot stay in the moment. They don't even understand what is the silence. I was speaking with a group last week. They asked me about silence, and I asked them, what do you think is silence? They said, silence is a lack of noise. I said, that's not true. The silence is alive. When you meditate and you hear something inside of you, you are completely silent. There is something there, a specific sound, which is inside of the silence. Actually, the sound is alive. The silence is alive. The sound inside there, it's inside of the silence. The silence is not the lack of noise. When you are in completely silence, you think it's lack of noise, but it's not. you can be in the middle of Oslo, the cars are coming and going, and you can still be in silence, in a real silence. So basically, the energy of 2014 and 15 is the energy of now, the energy of today. There is no tomorrow, no yesterday.
So this is the feminine energy.
The feminine energy.
You mean that this energy is pressing upon us. Where does it come from?
Mother Earth is sending all this energy, and it is coming inside of us, especially from down chakras. So we have the down chakra, the base chakra, the creation chakra, the navel chakra, and up, the solar plexus chakra. And all these chakras are charged with the energy which comes from Mother Earth. And the energy is different. The chakra energy is completely different now. When you inhale, and I'm especially the people who do spinal breathing, Kriya Yoga, they know when you inhale now the energy up on your spine, you feel something very, prior it was sharp, like you would feel like an arrow. Now it's flowing, the energy.
Mm.
It's very gentle. It's like a spring water, like a river going up. Energy is, the energy structure is completely different, the feminine energy. And we have to be like a river. We have to be in the moment. We have to listen to our heart, and to, because the heart is very feminine, and to do whatever our heart is telling us. We can say it's the ear of the heart.
Yes. And then you're expert in heart. What do you call it? Imagery.
Heart imagery.
Heart imagining.
Imagery.
Okay. What do you mean with that?
Heart imagery is a very interesting system. Immediately after Adam and Eve were on this planet, and we discussed last time something about Adam and Eve, maybe another time we'll discuss more extensively what happened Adam and Eve, who were actually Adam and Eve. The team which remains on this planet, and this is almost 40,000 years ago, was called Adamic race. There are a lot of books and articles about Adamic race. Some people call violet race, not because of the color of the skin.
Mm.
It was violet or indigo race, because the third eye has this energy. It's a indigo, violet towards indigo. Now this team, what was on that time on that planet, they didn't have Jesus, Buddha, Mohammed. There was nobody at that time to teach them. The only system they knew to use was imagery. And in Sumerian tablets...
Can you explain imagery a little bit?
I will.
First.
In Sumerian tablets, Enlil, they call the god, said to his people, close your eyes, and he gave an image. Now this is very important to understand. How is possible I give you an image, I ask you to close your eyes, and I give you a specific image, and something happened in you? And I'm telling you why. When I was in Tibet, in Amdo, the Tibetan explained me, whatever we see around us is an image. Anything, believe it, what you see now is an image. The light comes on this form, and it's reflected in your eyes, which is Daniel, but it's an image. You understand me? And it took me a while to understand that any image has the same energy. And indeed, any image has the same energy. It doesn't matter if it's an image, what you see in a picture, or me moving here. It's the same image. So in that time, Adamic race discovered that when you put different images to somebody who closed the eyes, you ask the person to see an image, that person started to have some changes in the mental body, the energy which moves to the left around you, and emotional body, the energy to move to the right around you. So they started to understand that you can get healed with imagery. I can give you for 10 minutes a set of images, and you can start working something. I work with a great master in Romania, Anna, and I remember in 1990, more than 24 years ago, she did the technique. Somebody came to her and she said, close your eyes. And she said, you walk now to a spring water. You take your eyes out. This man had a really bad infection. And clean your eyes. So this man saw this image. He was cleaning his eyes there. This man was going for 6 months to doctors. They didn't know what was going on. And he put all these drops in his. And it was a really trouble. In 3 days, this lady managed through imagery to clean him. The third day, he was perfectly healed. Now, behind that image, there is an energy. And when you start to not to make difference between the image that I'm giving to you and the image what you see around you, something happened in you. It triggers something. Now, when I've done it in Amdo, it was like 1 month. continuously. The great master there, Karma Dorje, even he was waking me up in the night. He said, wake up. And he said, close your eyes. And he gave me an image, which was cleaning me. It's impossible for me to do a workshop 1 month. Nobody will come in a retreat, maybe a few people. So I split it in 3 seminars. The first one is cleaning the past. Exercise which clean your past. It's very important to clean our past, because whenever you have a conflict with somebody, in your Leonardo sphere, some energy goes, and in my Leonardo sphere, some energy comes. So basically you change the energy and it remains in my Leonardo sphere and it affects me. So it's important to use a technique, we use a Tibetan technique to clean the past. You eject the energy which is not yours and you bring the energy back. So when you do this exercises cleaning the past, basically you get refreshed.
You use imagery, correct.
Some images. So it's very interesting, you get even young. Because you recover the energy from the past, you understand? It's a very interesting. So the first seminar is cleaning the past. The second one is healing and emotional clarity. This is very important. People should heal their emotional trauma. And the last one we call union with God, when basically you start to understand the divinity, and all around us it's one intelligence and one heart and all this. So basically what we are going to do Saturday and Sunday here in Oslo will be the first. For the first time in Norway, I'm teaching cleaning the past. I was teaching all over the world, but for the first time we are doing here in Oslo, and there is a team that's coming, especially my advanced students are coming to do it. So it's going to be something that they will remember, I can tell you.
But this imagery thing, it's all about you trusting in something, faith. When you believe something, is kind of affirmation. Is that what you can boil it down to?
Affirmation. When you give an image, there is a set of images that are related with your energy. Some people might really see, like for example, I ask you close your eyes and now see yourself swimming in the ocean. Some people might really see the color of the water. Some people might feel the ocean. Some people might see dolphins. You know. But some people might not see very well, might feel, especially the feminine energy, might sense the ocean, maybe smell the ocean. So for each other person is different, and it's coming from your experience, how you are prepared. Mm. You are more feminine or more masculine energy? What is inside of you? And each image is cleaning something, you know. Even some people don't see or sense very well, but suddenly they feel a muscle.
Mm.
Or they get frustrated out of nothing. The exercise started to irritate them because their emotional bodies start to rotate, you understand? So it's very interesting. And Tibetans, of course, they have the exercises from long time. It's not from Tibet, actually. Because what happened, Adamic race, after it was Mesopotamia, the Garden of Eden, where we know it was, they move, it's an area, it's called now Kapet Dag. It's right at the border Iran and Turkmenistan. So right there is Caspic Sea. That was the first headquarter of Adamic race, a very advanced civilization. And from there they move in 4 directions. China, Tibet, north of Europe, by the way, here they were, and Europe, Mediterranean island in Greece, and Egypt, and Israel, all this area, Middle East, and Americas. These 4 teams, they work for at least 25,000 years, just in Egypt. The imagery is the grandfather of all techniques. There were no yoga. People didn't know about Patanjali, didn't know about Babaji, Jesus, no way. The only thing they knew, images. They were so powerful to put an image out there and to start changing themselves. And believe me, it works. I mean, I work with the team from Russia. They are very advanced in imagery because we work with Dr. Catherine Scheinberg, and she is a world expert in imagery and dreaming. And they told me the heart imagery completely changed their perspective, their life. So, and I'm going in July and August in Moscow to teach them the last part, union with God.
Okay. But you're talking about imagery, and you haven't talked much about heart imagery.
Yeah, that is a very important question. There is a mental imagery, Kabbalistic imagery, but heart imagery. So prior to give you an image, I bring you to the heart.
Mm.
Your spirit, which is in the brain, start moving gently, gently to the heart. When you arrive in the heart, I give you an image. So there is no side effect. The energy moves, but it's unity, because the heart is unity, unity center, right?
Mm.
The heart is unity.
Mm.
The image comes to you in a completely safe way. It doesn't affect you. That's a very good question. It's good you ask, because it's important to understand. So, very welcome. Whoever wants to attend, I can tell you it's going to change. Some people
yes.
told me they changed their lives.
Yeah.
They couldn't believe it's such a simple technique. Just to give, I ask you, close your eyes, put your mask, close your eyes, and I start to tell you, see this? And after that, you stop. And you know what's interesting? Why it's so powerful? Because when I give you an image, after 20 seconds, I give you the next image. Your brain doesn't have time to start blah, blah. Your logic.
Okay.
So I put you from one image to another image. So far, like for 10-15 minutes, your mind completely shut off. So this is amazing, because in nowadays we are speaking and speaking, our mind doesn't stop, not even 1 second.
Mm.
So if you can stay 10 minutes without really thinking, seeing images, you start basically to reconnect yourself with your inner essence.
So if ordinary people, can I do this at home? Just
it's very easy.
If they have problems, I can go in and look at the problems yeah. and try to change it.
And with the workshop, I gave them a set of exercises like switch your energy, Tibetan cleaning the past, which you can apply today, now on the street. You don't need to go on a yoga special place and you start to do a Om and all this sound. You just, in that moment, when you get frustrated, when you drive your car on the highway, you apply that technique and it works perfectly.
You just change
you
the...
You switch your energy.
Change the problem to something positive.
Yeah, you switch your energy because we have this pure energy, and if we are able to switch our energy from this reaction, from this frustration, to feelings, love, courage, creation, harmony, trust, balance, you are already a great master. And believe me, we are all great masters.
Yes. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Do you have any, do you want to say any
yes.
last message?
I love you. and remember, all of you, you are very powerful. And you will go through 2014 and 15 and all next years in a very easy way. Just trust yourself. I love you.
Thank you very much, Daniel.
Thank you.
Yeah.